Hey guys, poolandfloor.com here. Today we're going to go over the BlueSquare Q360 valve, front, back, side to side, the whole nine yards. So here we go. This is the BlueSquare Q360 valve. So let's take this thing apart. We're going to take off the nut on the side. Maybe. All right, so once the nut is actually completely loose, we're going to take the band clamp off the entire valve to show you what the insides look like. This is a very simple valve. It's very nice to work on and it's very user friendly. So once we get that clamp off, as you can see here, this is the inside of the valve. That big blue thing is the turbine. The big round thing around the outside is the main body O-ring. So let's take it apart. Let's take the turbine out. Just everything slides out. So the turbine slides right out. Here's the bottom of it with the teeth. We'll come back to that. Here's the cassette. So it's one nice solid unit. There's no like putting pieces together. And this is the bottom of the valve. Pretty cool. So it's pretty straightforward and very, very simple. I'm gonna turn some light on here so you can see it. So as you can see in the bottom, some other valves have different ways of getting water through to the ports. These actually have slopes, which are really cool. So when the cassette's installed, there's no like anything that has to be pushed up, moved to the side or anything for water to actually get through it. So every time that the cassette turns like this, it gets to that port and water just kind of pushes down and into the port that's necessary and water is going to flow through there. So it's a very, very simplistic design. It's very awesome. And this is the turbine. So as you can see, when the turbine is installed, it just spins and turns the valve as necessary. Water comes in through the side of the valve and turns this turbine, and it just all day long just turns and cleans. Pretty straightforward. So let's see here if I can get this turbine out so I can show you what the bottom of it looks like. Very common here, when the turbines do go bad, the teeth on the bottom will actually start getting thinned out, and it'll pretty much, the turbine will spin, but the gears below won't turn. And also here too, the gears will thin out as well if the cassette goes bad, and the cassette will just stop turning at that point as well. So it'll look like it's spinning, but it's just not turning. So as you can see, when we reinstalled it, everything just kind of drops into place. It's really, really straightforward. So, and that's how you test it. You just spin it, put it on there, put the lid back on. So as you see here, this blue one, that's the older style lid. I'm not sure if they quite make those anymore, but they kind of switched to these black ones that are reinforced, and you can actually put a gauge on it now. So in my personal opinion, there's gonna be a lot less problems with the black ones than the blue ones. So if you have a blue one, I probably recommend just swapping it out when you can. It'll prevent it from cracking or breaking and causing a lot of water leak out. So as you can see here with the black one, we can put the gauge on it so you can see what kind of pressure you're getting from the system. See if there's a blockage or a backed up or anything like that that happens from there. So I personally like to see under 20 pounds of pressure on these things. If there's anything more than that, usually there's a blockage or maybe a different nozzle that should be installed a little bigger to allow more flow. But when you put the clamp back on, everything just kind of snugs on tight. Clamp goes on, nut goes back on. You want to use a pair of pliers for this to get it nice and tight, or sorry, a wrench, to get it all nice tight back together. And that's your Q360 valve complete. So what I like to do is take the gauge off and I'm going to put the nut back on. So it's optional. You don't have to have the gauge on there if you don't want to. It's just a nice feature to have every once in a while. So thanks for tuning in to poolandfloor.com. Stay tuned and we'll have some more videos for you. And subscribe today to get updates on all the new videos.